Hello, I'm heading off to the Sunshine Coast for work, just like my Brisbane trip a year ago, and I am excited. However, my lovely work wife, aka my closest colleague, has hurt herself and can't come, and we were looking forward to it for months. And last time I only had the guys around my age to hang with, and don't get me wrong, love them, but I don't really want to be the girl who is trailing around them all the time. So I do, thank goodness, have a girl who just joined. She makes me no longer the baby of the company.
Can you send? Oh,
oh my gosh. This is insane. I just arrived. This is so exciting. This is very different to last year, which was more in the middle of the CBD, 5-star hotel. This is a lovely resort with a lot of land, so it has more of a Hawaii vibe. I literally said to my colleague, I think I'm gonna just pretend I'm actually in Hawaii for this week because it kind of feels like it. Hello. Oh, you can't find your team? Have you texted Benny? They must be. I'm back in my room before dinner and I was just thinking how dumb I am for only getting one charger, because usually I'd pack a couple, one for my work, one for my personal phone, and I can charge both overnight together. But I accidentally brought the spare cord, which is so ironic, and not my actual one. Like, it was charging my normal phone this morning and I forgot to actually take it out when I left my house. So thank the Lord. We actually all got gifts as a welcome from the IT team, and it's literally a power bank. How crazy is it? Like, what are the chances I just forget and we literally get one of these as a gift? I am so happy right now. I am heading to a casual team dinner now. I was actually only told by my boss's boss to organize it literally a couple days ago. So I just pulled together this table for 25 people that is just in the hotel restaurant. I actually brought my aloe gel because I just knew that this week I really wanted to still keep up my skincare as much as possible. So even though I can't bring aloe plants themselves, I did bring this gel because I feel like it's just the next best thing. Also, the primary organizer of this event, who is called the office coordinator, got all of us MAs, so the people in my role, stress animals from Kmart, and mine's so cute. I named her Rosie. I just felt like she was pink. I kind of wanted to name her something generic, and I think she is so cute. Like, you can literally squeeze her when you're stressed. Like, it just looks funny. But yeah, I love her. She's so cute. I actually accidentally brought her to our very official meeting with the hotel staff by accident. Like, I genuinely just had her under my arm and looked down and I was like, oh, I brought her. So looked a little bit childish of me to be like walking in with her, but she's so adorable and I am so glad she's keeping me company here. I'm gonna head out now. This is my outfit. I have no idea where this top is from, and this is from my relative Eunice, so I also don't know where it's from. I'm also gonna be carrying around this bag because I just have so much to carry around, and this is my little lanyard where I have also kept my hotel key. I hope this isn't considered too revealing because I could wear my cardigan around the waist, but it's genuinely too hot and just sweltering kind of weather, so I really didn't want to. I also have these Miniso earrings.
Is that you?
finally back in my little home for the week. It's not even 9, but I decided to go back because I just kind of wanted my next few hours to be just relaxation. I also know that tomorrow morning is the latest that I can wake up.
I pushed the beds together. I obviously can't sleep in the center because there's the hole, but I just thought it'd be more fun to have a spacious bed, and I really want to eat the food that was left in the fridge for us, but I still feel really full from dinner, so I'm just waiting for that. Morning, survived a night here. I have woken up really early because of jet lag, so it's 7:15. But in Sydney time, it'd be an hour later, so it'd be 7:45. So my body just woke me up, and I only have to wake up at 8:30. So it's actually really early. But I woke up feeling the discomfort of my skin. Obviously, the aircon did slightly dry it out. It's not super bad, but it's just a little bit uncomfortable.
Just waiting for the skincare to fade. This is my outfit. I have a Hilfiger cap. And then I have a dress from Glassons, and I'm gonna carry my backpack around today because for the sessions I want to have my laptop and iPad with me, so I thought may as well swap it from the little handbag I have.
As soon as I walked outside, my glasses steamed up. Like, that is how humid it is.
Hi, here's my look for tonight's barbecue. Most people are here now, so I just have jeans and a nice top from Ali. I feel like these jeans are my mom's. I feel like maybe, again, not super appropriate, but I just love this outfit so much, I'm willing to risk it. So I have my earrings and I just have like a whole lot of jewelry on. I'm just a lot more glam than I usually would be, I feel. I finished a day of work where basically I can duck in and out of the meetings because they're not relevant to my role. I'm more there to facilitate and make sure everything's running smoothly. So we had these issues with the air conditioning, like all these rooms, ACs weren't working and people were complaining non-stop today, and the hotel staff is just so stressed from us. So I totally get that they must be so panicky right now, but yeah, just too many issues where things aren't really going super smoothly, but I was in a room that was mostly air conditioned, so that was good. But yeah, now I'm gonna head off to the barbecue. My colleague messaged me and said she wanted to walk together because our rooms aren't too far, so gonna meet her.
Can you hear the water? How come we can't see though? Is this called the audience? It's construction. There's the road.
I just got back into my room after a whole day of work. The main part of my role doing work is over for the week, so that's good. But I was rushing this morning, putting the clean my room tab on my door, and I accidentally put it the opposite direction. So it basically said, please do not clean my room. So I just come back to an untouched and dirty room, and I'm not happy about that because it's literally my fault. I'm just ready for dinner now. The vibe is Coachella, and it's gonna be called Bosscella because of our company name combined. So I just have this necklace that I got from my mom, and then this top is actually from my sister. And then I have a skirt, which is from Supre, I feel like. I've had it for years now. Very sad that I can't do makeup, but honestly, in the heat, everyone's is probably going to end up melting anyway.
Is a festival, and a festival is a celebration. All right.
I just got back all glittered up, literally have it all over my arms. It was super fun. We actually had a band composed of people all from the company, which was really nice. To see everyone showcase their talent, you don't always get that in a work environment, so I think that was cool for them. And then there was actual DJ dancing, so we just did that for a little bit and then found this really nice air-conditioned room, and basically there were about 20 people just sitting there. So we just chilled for a bit and decided that tomorrow, a few of us waking up for the sunrise, so we're gonna go over to the beach for that. So I have to pretty much sleep now if I want to be able to get a good amount of shut eye for plenary and tomorrow night's gala.
I don't think the boys are coming. I've actually been waiting for about 10 minutes now, and I thought because I can sort of see a little bit of the sunrise at this point of view at our meeting spot, I might just watch it myself here. I don't think they're even awake. I don't know if they like planned to actually not come but told me they would come, or if they're just actually sleeping in and just missed alarms. I don't know how you can
just miss alarms though. Like if you want to wake up with a sunrise, you will. I'm just going to maybe watch myself and then go back to bed because I am also pretty tired.
The boys turned out had some sort of alarm issue and woke up a whole hour later, but they went on a walk and I tried to sleep. And there were these animals trying to get the plate of food that I left outside my room. I was told by the lobby too, so that's why I put it out there, but because all the hotel rooms are obviously outdoors, a lot of animals came and they were scraping at it, eating it. I don't know what kind of animals. I was really scared that it was a massive kangaroo and I called reception and told them to pick it up because it was getting out of hand. I was like, the room next door is going to hear the scraping and wake up too.
This top, which I bought from Cotton On Body, and then this is from Ali. I don't know if this again is too hoey, but it's just so hot. I just feel like the temperature is horrible, and I always like my outfits. I mean, I plan them through before I travel, so I just don't want to waste my outfit. So here it is. Hope I don't get caught up on it.
We got to add in the jewelry. I have this necklace and I have these earrings, and now it's time to really quickly spread all the skincare in because I really need to win the challenge. I don't know if I'm too late. I don't know if I'd be tired if I did it now.
Hello, it is great coming back to a finally clean room, and the plate that was outside is finally cleared.
Some updates while I quickly get ready for the pool. I'm meeting Catherine there while a lot of people participate in Survivor. Looked like there were maybe about 60 people there. On top of me being unfit, I literally would not be able to do something like Survivor in this humidity. It's just horrible right now. But today's plenary was actually really nice. So if you don't know what that means, it is basically when everyone from the conference comes together, because the last couple of days we were in divisions. I don't have footage because it was a bit more formal than other times, but basically it was really interesting to just hear from all the different presenters. So firstly, we actually heard from a guest speaker who basically goes around doing public speaking, sharing her story. She was actually a survivor of the 2005 London train terrorist attack. And it's really uncanny because my mum mentioned that to me just last week. And I said to her, oh, I'm only kind of familiar with 9/11 plus the past terrorism from maybe the past decade. So I don't really know about that one, even though I have probably heard about it somewhere. It was really nice to hear from her. Obviously so inspiring, a really amazing act of courage. And she obviously just had a really nice heart in the first place as well. A lot of people would just be so bitter and would never be able to recover from that type of thing 19 years ago, because she was a double amputee and she had to really focus on balancing herself when standing up, because obviously she can only really feel her torso. So it was just so interesting to hear the journey that she's been on since and all the people she met along the way. And she really wanted to hone in on the message of humanity and just really believing in the kindness of others and being kind yourself. So that was really nice as well. And then we moved on to an interview between a patient and a doctor. Situation that was also really sad health-wise. So the patient basically had heart issues and had to retire really early. And so the doctor was interviewed too next to him, and they were just saying how much it's changed his life. And he just feels like he's basically back to the person he was before his health issues with the heart. So that was really nice to hear. And obviously that's using one of our heart devices. And then we moved on to more company internal kind of issues. So for example, just knowing the stats on how well we're doing, how well we did last year, and the aims for above and beyond, like having people who are top of the leadership team talking to us about that, talking about DICE, which is diversity, inclusion, culture, equity and environment. I'm literally part of a couple of those alliances, so I really should know that. But yeah, so it was really nice to see the different videos that have been filmed, commercial excellence, just all of these different divisions and departments that were more in the internal company sense. And then we also heard from someone who was both a urologist, so he's a doctor part of my division, and also was a patient of a device that we use. Basically, a lot of guys over 45 years old have an enlarged prostate, and it basically makes them pee a lot and just makes them really lethargic and obviously just not well. So some people need to have this procedure done where you treat your BPH, and it's called Resume Therapy, and it's basically something that you stick up your prostate and the mist actually will just make that
inflamed part go down, and then eventually you won't have to pee as much. You won't be just like pressing on your bladder that much. So that was really cool too, because he was both a doctor and then also recognized that he needed to become the patient. I do like how they add that extra touch in every year, because when you're so invested in your role or your division or department every single day and you're thinking about how many tasks I have to do, for example, sometimes I get up to 90 tasks to do and I just get so overwhelmed being really stressed from work. And then you hear about these patient stories and you're like, wow, this is actually worth it, because even though I'm that little bit of helping a patient recover from their health problems, it is worth it when you hear those stories, because you sincerely feel like you are part of a very helpful to society sort of company. So I never really expected myself to be in that. When you study marketing, you don't really think about, oh, I'm going to be part of such an altruistic business, but you are in this kind of med device company, and that's really nice. So yeah, it was cool to hear from everyone. We just had lunch, did some last minute mail packing.
Best. Cute.
Sink fallen.
I like falling in. But she's good. Look, she's going so well. I trust you right now.
Apparently CRM.
No way. Wish we did. Well, it's like the only video.
We did a couple races in the pool and I was final, which was really embarrassing because I was talking about how I actually swam for a decade, but the last time I swam for fitness consistently was when I was 17. So obviously I'm very out of whack because I also don't do daily exercise. So that was a little bit embarrassing, but anyway, we move on with life. I have definitely gotten sunburnt, but I have also gotten tan. So I am pretty scared. I might've done a bit of backtracking with the healing of my skin, but hopefully it's not too bad, at least for the next day or so, just at least till I get home, because I just can't do anything about that. Like, it was worth the fun, so worth the face burns. Again, it's just so sensitive right now, I can't really do anything much about it.
I am just about ready. This is a dress that I've worn for a wedding reception borrowed from my sister. I have the same necklace on and then no earrings. Obviously, I could only do lips, so I'm really hoping that tonight I'm kind to myself. I don't feel too insecure about not wearing any makeup. I have the really glowy layering on the skincare look going on. I also have my Guess clutch, so I'm basically just gonna look like this when I walk around. Because my hair is wet, it fell into a very nice bun that I usually can't do because my hair is really thick. So this is the slick look I try and go for that I can only really do when my hair is wet like this.
The flash!
So moving right along.
I just got back. It's just past midnight, which is way earlier than I returned last year. I just felt really tired. Like, by the time it hit 10, I felt like it was 1. I just feel like I'm becoming such a grandma. I love dancing, but only to songs that I know. And so I really only properly danced to a few songs, and I had to request one of them. So it wasn't really my vibe. I was just like, gonna wait till I get tired, and my heels really hurt because the walk to my room was pretty long. So otherwise, the awards night was really nice. I'm kind of losing my voice as I do after I dance, but it was a really good time with everyone. I feel like, having been my second NSM, I just knew it was gonna happen this time, and it wasn't all new and fresh to me like last year. So it was such a good time. I feel like it was a different enough venue that it felt like a different experience. Like, if we were in the same type of hotel this time around, then it would have felt a lot like the same. So that made it really nice. And even though the nature is kind of gray sometimes, like when I tried to get into my room just then, there was literally this massive cricket hoppy thing outside my door, and it was ugh. But besides that, I really enjoyed my time here. I am planning to wake up around 9 because I've actually already mostly packed. So it's just everything else that needs to go into my bag. I'm just really grateful that I'm part of a company that gives me the opportunity to travel yearly for this. It's really fun. It kicks off the year so well. It really does do its job. It's not like, oh, this company wastes its money by doing a bunch of celebrations for a week. It's like, it actually helps you with rapport and just wanting to work for the company. I feel like it really helps with that. I'm really grateful that I get to be part of this.
That is a wrap. I just finished packing my bags. I am very surprised I managed to fit everything because I did have a few extra items, so it was a little bit squishier than it was on the way here, but I managed to just rearrange some things and have to put some things into my backpack. I'm on the way to breakfast. I feel like most people might be there now, so they might be leaving as I enter, but I am running early on schedule because my dad called me a little bit before my alarm went off and I thought, oh my gosh, well, I'm awake anyway, so I may as well answer the call. This is my dress. I can't remember where it's from. I also can't really remember where I got these from. So yeah, really chill, really casual. Bye, room.